And welcome to Monday Morning Questions with Charles Botenstein at Botenstein Properties International. Today we're going to be discussing the first of two questions. Number one is about listing with a broker. I'm going to go through just a little bit about it. I think this has been beaten to death, is whether you have the patience to actually list with a broker or you don't. Here comes the question. Question says, I'm thinking about selling my apartment in a village co-op without a broker. I'm willing to do the legwork myself, but I'm wondering if this approach is penny wise and pound foolish. Wow, that's I haven't heard that one. I like that. Is a good broker worth his or her fee? Question mark. Any suggestions for selling by owner? Okay, so, wow, selling by owner. Number one is if you sell by yourself, that means you're going to be pounded by 100 brokers, number one is you're gonna be pounded with hundreds of brokers trying to get your listing. So you need patience. Number two is you need patience in the fact that there's gonna be a lot of dumb buyers. There's a lot of buyers that are not working with brokers. They have no idea about the process. They have no idea how to buy. They have no idea how to get through a co-op, how to put together a board package to make sure it's correct. I think that's the biggest thing is we went through this big, StreetEasy was introduced to the market, and then from 2010 to 2013, 2014, every dollar counted. Like, every home price that was being sold counted. Like, you needed to get, because otherwise you were cutting even, you weren't making any profit, you might have needed all of the money out of the home. So StreetEasy selling on, an owner selling on themselves, selling for themselves, was really popular. And then after that, it actually got less popular because people actually care about their time more than their money. I know it's the old, your time is your money, but people care about their time. That's why Uber's really popular. That's why a lot of people do things like fly instead of drive, or they fly instead of take a train, is because they value their time. If you value your time, you will hire a broker because the broker's been through it. The broker knows how to handle the objections. The broker knows how to list it, to bring on the correct marketing, to distribute it, as well as that if you list it and you put it on StreetEasy, which is obviously the number one website by far in New York City, is that you only open it to the public. You don't open it to brokers. And 90% of all transactions based on absolutely no real, scientific data, but this is what I've been told over and over from big firms, is that 90% of their deals, and they're doing probably 70, 75% of all the deals that they do in New York City, the big firms do about 75% of all of the transactions in New York City. And they say, all the firms say about 90%, there's a buyer's agent and there's a seller's agent. And the reason being is that sellers, for sale by owners, just don't want to do it. That's just number one. They just don't want to do it. They don't have the patience. They don't have the marketing. And you're only opening it up to StreetEasy when, in fact, since 90% of all deals are done with a buyer's agent, that means that all the buyer's agents, they don't look on StreetEasy. We have all of our internal systems, which has building information, has just a slew of just past history and data that we need just in case we're putting in an offer that's unique or special. So I use, there's OLR, there's other great internal systems, but unless you open it up to all the brokers and the public, that's the only way to market it correctly. And then on top of that, you have to be willing to be there for open houses, deal with dumb questions and just a slew of brokers calling and emailing and harassing and writing notes and everything else because they want your listing. So if you want to go through that, awesome. I would say, out of all the for sale by owners, because I approach for sale by owners, a lot of for sale by owners approach us, is percentage-wise, 10% end up selling on their own. And all of them are in condos because putting together a co-op package is miserable. There's a lot of board turndowns lately, and nobody wants to go through a board turndown. A lot of the owners try and put the broker compensation into the purchase price, which is smart. But the thing is, the co-op doesn't want to see that. So the co-op says, that's great that you got $900,000 for your apartment, but the going rate is $950,000. And the reason they won't approve a home for $900,000 if the going rate for apartments is $950,000 is because that means their apartments are worth less because one home just sold for $900,000 instead of $950,000. So there's a slew of reasons before listing to even consider. You're going to have all these people through your home. You obviously negotiating if you're nervous or whatever. I don't really care. I go right to the point. And I'm talking about good brokers. I'm not talking about, the bottom 80%. I'm talking about the top 20% brokers. Listing with them is well worth your money. It's well worth your time, your headache, hassle, co-op, management, showings, negotiating, board package, listing it, marketing, picking up the phone call. It's just, it's up to you. You know, I'm a proponent that as long as you can handle it, have done it before, then do it. But just be aware that it's a long, arduous process that is taken for granted because of TV shows and things like that until you actually go through it on your own. Most owners, regardless of how wealthy or, you know, first-time homebuyers, whatever, they're like, just handle it. It's the same thing with buyers' agents. It's like, why, if everything's listed on StreetEasy, why am I going through an agent or why am I using an agent? It's just like, just handle it. Just do it. So if you're that type of person, then do it. You know, where you are just saying, I'll do it, I've done it, I know what I'm doing. And then the other 80% say, handle it, take care of it. But either way, hopefully the home sells. You know, nobody wants a home not selling and the board doesn't want it. As long as it's at a good price, the board package was obviously given properly prepared, collated, there's enough copies, everything signed, it looks beautiful and pristine. So anyway, subscribe to this video. We come out with a new question every single Monday and Tuesday. And follow us on Instagram. Those are our two favorite social media networks. Again, Charles Botenston from Botenston Properties International. Talk to you guys soon.